plaintiff, Sharinda Oten, was friends with the defendant, and she allowed her and her children to move in with her. Sharinda claims after the defendant moved out without notice, she and her daughter, the co-defendant, attacked her. So she's suing. Defendants Calvina Collins and her daughter Tamira Jones admit that they got in a fight with Sharinda, and Calvina caught the fight on camera. However, Tamira claims the attack occurred only after Sharinda threatened her with mace. They're countersuing for the assault.
All rise. This court is now in session. The Honorable Judge Greg Mathis presiding. You may now be seated.
Before we get into the case, I want to acknowledge some men who were very helpful in the distribution of water to the city of Flint, an effort myself and many others have been working on. We took approximately about 100,000 cases. In the course of a year, and the brothers from Moore Science Temple, led here today by Brother Fuque Bay. Thank you all. They were there to help pack it at the Mathis Community Center where we had the donations coming. They were there to help unload it, them along with the Nation of Islam members. And we appreciate their help. And they also have a strong presence in the prison system because one of their goals is to strengthen black men while they're behind bars to turn from crime and to come home and serve their community and strengthen their community. So that's the type of rehabilitation I like, and thank you all for doing it. Start with you, ma'am.
Okay, so it all began in 2017. Me and Calvina, we met at a homeless shelter, Casa Maria. While we were there, we became really good friends, like really, really good friends. I'm not gonna lie, really good friends.
All right, and you all left the shelter at some point?
Yep, we left the shelter. I moved out of town, then came back to Milwaukee when I had my son. Mm-hmm. Well, after I had my son. So then we kept in touch. I'd be in the hospital a lot. She has health issues. So when I'm in the hospital, she came and saw me. When my son was there, she came. So our relationship was great. Like, I consider her a real true friend. I really did.
Okay. And fast forward to 19 is when the mess started.
Yep.
Before we get to the incident, tell me what was going on that preceded the incident.
Okay, well,
when did things turn bad?
I want to say it was June. Calvina and her three youngest daughters came to stay with me. Everything was good. We didn't have any problems. Little problems started to come because she worked third shift, so she would leave at nighttime, and she was supposed to get off at 7 or 8 in the morning, but it was days where she wouldn't come till after 3 in the afternoon. Her oldest that was staying there was 12.
That's not true.
I have evidence. But her oldest that was 12, she was supposed to be watching the other two, which is okay as long as I'm there. But it was times where I couldn't go to my doctor's appointments or do things that I needed to do because she wasn't there, and I'm not gonna just leave her kids there at my house. So I spoke to her, I text her and everything. I even text her baby daddy, and I'm just like, okay, it's cool that they're here, but don't keep leaving them here with me. Like, that's a problem. It's a problem. Then when I say something to them, to the kids about cleaning up or being too loud or whatever the case may be, they told me one time that she said they didn't have to do anything. Okay, so of course a problem became, because if y'all here, that's the least y'all can do. If it was a problem that she had, her kids didn't like me, or whatever the case may be, why continue to leave them there with me?
So what did that lead to?
So we had the conversation, the talks or whatever. It got better, I'm not gonna lie, it got better. But then some days it was the same thing. Then Tamira, which is the other defendant, she has a son. Her son is a year older than mine. He would hit my son, like, a lot. So at first I would tell Calvina, like, can you, you know, tell him to stop hitting him or whatever case may be. They're kids, so I understand that. But don't keep doing it. If we're all sitting right there, say something, especially if you don't want me to say anything.
You don't. When your kid hits my son or hits anyone else, you don't say nothing. You act like he's innocent.
No,
so that's not fair for you to say.
Not.
True.
But, okay, so even when the incident first occurred, with Tamira's son hitting my son. I said something to Galvina, and then it continued. So then I inboxed Tamira on Facebook, and I have messages about that as well. Just telling her, like, okay, I don't mind you guys coming over here, but if he can't keep his hands off my son, then y'all gonna have to, period, point, like, stop it. So she said that it was gonna stop. It didn't. And then,
That's when it led to this incident.
Yes,
let me hear from you all, whoever wants to speak first.
Hi, Judge Mathis. Just brief history. I did meet Sharenda Red, which she goes by Red, is her nickname, in 2017.
Dirty Red or Red?
No, just Red.
Dirty Red is more like it. Yes. Dirty Red is more like it.
You know why.
Okay.
You know
why. Okay.
All right, go.
We did meet at a homeless shelter, Casa Maria, in Milwaukee. We did hit it off. I took Red under my wing as a little sister because she does have medical issues. Okay. And so back in June, I was getting out of a domestic violent relationship, and she pretty much asked me and opened up her doors to me and my children, my three children. I did work third shift, so I would leave out at approximately like 11 o'clock at night. And my children were there with Red. About 2 weeks in of us being there, my children started stating to me that she would be doing petty things to them when I leave for work. And so I addressed it. You know, I confronted Red about it. She rejected even to speak with me in regards to what my children were accusing her of.
No, we spoke
about
it.
So that was a big issue for me. I trust you to the fact that I moved into your home. I trusted you to the fact to leave my children with you while I go to work third shift. And pretty much you betrayed me and was doing bogus stuff to my kids when I wasn't around. My children told me this right away. I went to Red and addressed it right away.
How long did you all stay there?
Approximately 3 weeks.
Okay, and she addressed it or failed to, you said?
She failed to. She got up and ran in her room and closed her door to the fact that I had to talk to her through her bedroom door.
Okay, and this is what started the strife in the relationship. Tell me what happened with the assault.
Okay, so prior to that, they moved out. I want to say it was July 21st, 22nd, somewhere in there. Calvina and Tamira were at the house. They were in the living room. I was in my room sleep with my niece and my son.
You weren't
sleep? When I woke up and came out the room, my niece went out first, and then she came in like, so what, did they go to the laundromat? All of their stuff is gone. So when she said that, that's when I went out there. I walked around the house, and everything was completely gone. All of their stuff was gone. All of the cabinets in my kitchen were open, completely empty. Like the refrigerator was open. Like, my house door was not locked. She had a spare key. She didn't lock my door or anything. She didn't tell me that she was moving out or anything. So, okay, I text her and I said, I'm not tripping. That's cool. Just bring my spare key. Okay, so here it is, August 1st. On my way coming from the gas station, I see her, Calvina and Tamira. Tamira's driving. They ride past me. So when they roll past me, they stop and park in front of my house. By the time I made it up to my house, Calvina raised the window down and she said, what up, G? Let me get my kids' coats. That's fine. She had about 7 coats upstairs. I went upstairs, grabbed the coats. When I came back down, I opened the door. I had my keys in my hand.
And your mace.
Yeah, my mace is on my key rings.
I intended on
opening my house door to go out to their car to hand them their coat. I had to have my keys in my hand because how was I going to get back in my lock? Okay, but as soon as I opened the door, they're both out of the car. They rushed me.
So when they rushed,
no, I opened the door. I was gonna, I was trying to walk out.
You didn't say come in?
No, absolutely not. No, I had all of their coats and I was proceeding to walk out. I opened the door and as soon as I opened the door, they rushed me.
You a liar.
Thank you, I'm sure. But Judge Mathis,
yeah.
Yeah. So they rushed me. When they rushed me, yes, I did have my keys in my hand and I had a thing of mace on my hand. As soon as they rushed me, I smelled nothing but alcohol. Tamira had really long weave braids, so I was able to, she put me in the headlock. I was able to wrap her weave around her neck. So,
Lord.
You know, she had my headlock.
You a big
sure.
I'm positive.
She is lying.
This is Anoa. This
she
is
lying,
unbelievable.
Anoa. And I was
she's
pulling
lying.
It. I was on the door, though, because they rushed me, so I'm on the
Who's
door.
She a good liar?
Sir, they pulled out so much of my hair. I'm a liar, but look at this. This is not a liar. Look at all of my hair. They pulled all of it.
You got that because you tried to mace me, and I was not going to let you mace me. So of course, you deserved it.
When
you deserve it.
I opened the door. They didn't.
And you had your mace open.
They didn't.
I did it in.
Oh, they like did that, that. Because Calvina ended up running back out to get her phone. She put a coat inside the door. Ooh, like wait. She recorded the end of the fight. Before she ran out to get her phone or whatever, she already took my mace and my keys out of my hand.
How did it end?
They ran out.
Okay.
With all the coats right front. There. I still have their coats.
From whomever wants to speak.
Right.
I mean, I dare this girl. She got a lot of nerve right now.
Tell
standing
me
in your face, lying the way she's lying. Your Honor, I got this video. Can you please allow me to show you the video?
Okay.
This what you wanted, D. This what you wanted. Now beat her to my... This what you wanted. You talking all that grimy, greasy on my phone.
D. You want a bite?
Yeah.
You want a bite? You want a bite?
You already lumped up.
You want a bite?
You already lumped up, Red.
Huh? Hey, let me go. Huh? Let me go.
You bite that off. Since you want to bite, now she biting your the off.
All right, that's enough. What I did here is the motive.
Thank you.
You kept encouraging the assault instead of breaking it up, instead of saying, stop, stop. Come on, don't do that. Giving somebody time to retreat or breaking it up and so you all can get away. Instead, you were encouraging it. And you shared your motive. Your motive was because of the things she said on the phone. I heard you say, yeah, talk to her like you was talking on the phone. Beat her, beat her, beat her, A.B. Beat her, beat her. You beat it. Your claim is dismissed and yours is granted. Have a good day. Beat it, beat it.
That's all you is, a bum, a petty thief.
You're
gonna hurt me.